स्टूडेंट्स गुड मॉर्निंग. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड ए टॉपिक इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइन. इन दिस टॉपिक वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न सो मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट्स. वी हैव लर्न पॉइंट लाइज ऑन लाइन और नॉट लाइज ऑन द लाइन. देन वी हैव लर्न इफ पॉइंट लाइज ऑन द लाइन देन हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट द अननोन वेरिएबल. देन वी हैव लर्न कि लाइन्स आर कॉन्कुरेंट और नॉट कॉन्कुरेंट. Then we have learned about the concept slope. After that, we have learned the conditions for the slope, that is for the parallel line and for the perpendicular line. How we can find out the slope for these two conditions. Then we have learned the conditions of the collinearity. Now, in continuation with this topic, today we will learn how we can find out the equation of a line when slope and y-intercept are given, when slope and one point is given, and when two points are given there. Today we will learn how we can find out the equation of a line with these three conditions. Now, today topic is how to find out the equation of a line when a slope and y-intercept is given, when slope and one point is given, and when only two points are given there. Now, first condition is when a slope and a y-intercept is given, how we can find out the equation of a line there. Now, I am taking one example. Find equation of a line. We have to find out the equation of a line if y-intercept. Now, y-intercept is 2 given to you. And slope is 3. Slope means value of m is given to you. Y-intercept is always represented as a C letter. So, according to solution, y-intercept is C, C is equal to 2 given, slope M, M is equal to 3 given. Now, equation of a line, Y is equal to MX plus C. Equation of a line, Y is equal to MX plus C. Now, we will put the simple value here. M value is 3, we will put the value 3 here. C value is 2, we will put the value 2 there. Therefore, equation of a line is y is equal to 3x plus 2. This is the simple form when slope and y-intercept is given. Now, the second type, when slope and one point is given there, how we can find out the equation of a line? The equation of a line in that form is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now, where y1 and x1 are the passing through point and m is slope of line Now, I am taking one more example for more understanding. Find the equation of a line whose slope is minus 4 by 3 and which passes through minus 3 and 4. Now, passes through, passing through point means x1 and y1 is given to you. Slope means m is given to you. Now, according to solution, slope m is equal to minus 4 by 3 is given to you. Passing through point is minus 3 and 4. That means x1 is equal to minus 3 and y1 is equal to 4 there. Then we will apply the equation of a line. Equation of a line is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now we will put the values y minus y1. Y1 is 4. We will put the value 4 there. Slope is minus 4 upon 3. We will put the value minus 4 upon 3 there. X minus sign is already there. And minus x1 is there. So that means minus 3 value we will put there. This minus and this minus will make the positive sign. Minus 4 numerator will be multiplied to this bracket and denominator will be multiplied to the that side. When we will multiply this side by applying the arrow method, it will be equal to 3y minus 12 is equal to minus 4x minus 12. Now minus 12 and minus 12 we will cancel that side. It will be equal to 4x we will shift to that side with the positive sign. 4x plus 3y is equal to 0. This is the required equation of line there when one point and slope is given. Now the last point is when only two points are given. In that statement you will having only the x1 y1 and x2 y2 passing through points. You will find out first slope there with the help of that given two points. We will find out slope m is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Then we will apply the same equation of line condition, that is the y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now I am taking one example there. The coordinate of two points P and Q. Now two points are there. 2,6 and minus 3,5. Two points means first is x1, y1. Second one is x2 and y2 is given to you. First of all, you have to find out the gradient, the another name of the slope of PQ. Then you have to find out the equation of PQ. Third, the coordinate of the point where PQ intersect the x-axis. Now, according to solution, we will proceed with step by step. First, we will find out the slope there. First point is to find out slope. What is given there? Two points are given. That means x1, y1, x2, y2. P point is 2,6. Q point is minus 3 and 5. Therefore, x1 is equal to 2, y1 is equal to 6, x2 is equal to minus 3, y2 is equal to 5. Then we will find out the slope by applying formula. M is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Now we will put the value, because slope is for the point PQ, we will put the value PQ, MPQ. 5 minus y1 is 6, x2 is minus 3, minus x1 is 2 there. Plus minus, sign of bigger term subtract the number, minus 1. Minus minus, sign of minus add the number. So minus and minus sign cancel. So slope is 1 upon 5 there. Slope we have find out there. First part we have done, that is the slope of the PQ. Now it's the turn of the second part, that is the equation of PQ. Now, to find the equation of PQ, we will apply the same equation formula there, that is y minus y1 is equal to MPQ. We have to find out the equation of line PQ. That's why we will apply here MPQ, slope of PQ, x minus x1. Now you will put the values there. Y minus 6, 1 upon 5, x minus 2. Now, by cross multiply, 5, y minus 6 is equal to 1 into x minus 2. By applying the arrow method, you will find out the equation x minus 5y plus 28 is equal to 0 there. Now, we have also solved the second part there. Now, the third part there, where we have to find out the intersected point PQ at x-axis. X-axis means x, 0. Now, x, 0 point, we will put this point in the required equation. We will put this point x and 0 in the required equation. When we put the value x as a x and y as a 0 in this equation, so it will be equal to x minus 5 into 0 plus 28 is equal to 0. When we solve the value, तो x will be equal to minus 28. Therefore, required intersected point at x-axis is minus 28, comma 0. Now, students, I hope now you people are able to do the question related to this topic. You will receive one link. Go through that link also. Do your worksheet.